Well, thank you very much, friends. Merci beaucoup. I am coming from Spain to Domino, that they give us that beautiful space to make a demonstration. And what I will do today is something totally different to my other demos, and I hope you like it. Recently, we released the new RAS product, the new RAS, which is something totally amazing, especially for people who don't know how to pay Rust. And I think that could be interesting to explain it because it is a bit complex, but at the same time, it's very natural and easy, like the typical Rust in the reality. In fact, I am talking about this, okay? I will explain you how to use, I will explain you why it's a bit complex and why it's easy at the same time, but I will explain you step by step today. Remember that until now, for most of you, who made tanks here? Tanks, military vehicles, blindes, and the rest of the people, planes or
planes?
The planes doesn't get rust.
There's no rust.
Okay. So until now, most of the modelers were used to do something like that, painted with acrylics. This is painted with acrylics. It is in a video in our channel, so if someone wants to see it, they can see how to paint something like that. But this is this need time and a lot of work and a lot of knowledge about colors and many other things. If you want to translate a bit.
Yeah, sure. Donc là, ce que Mick vous présente, donc ça a été réalisé avec des acryliques. Ça fait d'ailleurs l'objet d'une vidéo sur sa chaîne YouTube. Et donc ça prend beaucoup de temps de réaliser ce type d'effet avec des acryliques.
And actually, we can do in that way, or we can use another method with the natural rust products that will allow us to create random effects that usually is the most difficult when we are painting models.
Donc là, en fait, sur ce deuxième exemple, ça a été réalisé avec le set rouille, et du coup, ça facilite l'obtention d'effets aléatoires de la rouille, donc beaucoup plus réaliste.
Well, one good example is what we are looking in the actual war in Ukraine, and we can see vehicles with amount of different tones and shades of rust colors, and very random. Some parts are black and other parts are like white, other parts in red or orange, and that is really difficult to paint when we are using acrylics.
Quand on utilise en fait des acryliques, là on le voit bien sur des photos de référence, c'est difficile de rendre l'ensemble des différentes tonalités de couleurs qu'on peut avoir, puisque ça peut aller du blanc, du noir et différents tons de orange.
We have colors to paint rust, like you can see here. That is how we painted rust until now. And if you know how to do it, it's okay. For the guys who make planes, that you say before, no, the planes doesn't get rust. I remember when I was in China, in Beijing, I was in a military museum for planes, and they have around 10 or 12 Sturmovik, and they were totally rusted, full of rust, because those planes are armored, with heavy armor plates, in the sides, in the front, in every places. So it was incredible how to see those planes full of rust. Obviously, it's not the same a plane made in aluminum and fabric that are totally another history, no? But there are planes who get rust.
Alors bien sûr, sur les avions, forcément, on a moins l'occasion, l'opportunité de réaliser de la rouille, mais il y a quand même des exemples importants. Mig parle d'avoir vu donc en Chine une douzaine, par exemple, de Shturmovik sur lesquels les éléments de blindage étaient particulièrement rouillés. Donc il existe quand même sur les avions des possibilités de réaliser des effets de rouille quand il s'agit de plaques de blindage en acier, même si la plupart des avions sont effectivement en aluminium.
So, what I will explain you today is how to make this, but with a different method.
Donc, ce qu'il va expliquer aujourd'hui, c'est comment réaliser cet effet avec une méthode différente.
Okay. So here I have one example of a turret painted with the URAS products, and this is an example painted with acrylics and typical and classic methods.
À droite, on a un exemple de ce qui est la tourelle du T55 qui a été traitée avec le U-Rust 7 et sur à gauche avec la méthode classique aux acryliques.
Okay. The first thing that you can see in this example is what I told you before, the random aspects of the rust. Random. Aleatory. No, I just explained that the main aspect when we see something made with the URAS is that it's very random, aleatory.
Oui.
Random.
Donc là on a un résultat, on voit bien qu'on a un résultat.
On voit bien que là on a un résultat qui est
beaucoup plus aléatoire.
Beaucoup plus aléatoire.
Okay. So how we can achieve those effects, no? Especially for people who are not used to paint rust, how we can do something like that. So, the beginning of this process will be this one. We will primer or model, or not only model, can be a component for a diorama, something like that, the roof, structures, or any other things that we can imagine can be rusted. Okay.
Donc n'importe quel élément, que ce soit un modèle, mais également des éléments de diorama, peut être traité avec.
Okay. So we will start priming our model with a black color. I use a Titan spray because I like to go faster, and the black color will be perfect to start working with our products.
Donc on commence par appliquer.
On commence par appliquer une sous-couche noire.
Dans le cas présent, il s'agit d'une bombe de la gamme Titan.
So, I will start with this. Okay. I will start using those three products. The good thing is that there are many different colors. Let me show you one second. We have rust oxide patina, and copper, for example, that can be also for bronze, and many other different colors, which is very interesting. Depending which color we use, we will obtain different effects with the rust. And also, there are two reactives, okay? The two reactives and the combination of those two reactives will create different effects in the surfaces, and you will see now, okay?
Donc il va commencer par utiliser différents types de produits qui vont être ensuite complétés avec l'association de deux activateurs. Donc vous voyez que sur ces produits, vous avez des tonalités, des couleurs très, très variées, destinées justement à reproduire cette variation de tonalité de la rouille.
Well, we will start applying the first colors.
Je commence par appliquer la première couleur.
Just shake it because this contain like metal particles that will react with the reactive chemicals.
Il faut bien agiter parce que ces produits contiennent des particules de type métallique qui vont réagir avec les activateurs.
Okay. I will take a normal brass. Doesn't matter if it's flat or round. This is up to you.
Donc en fonction de ce que vous souhaitez réaliser, vous pouvez utiliser un pinceau plat ou un pinceau classique rond.
And we will paint like a normal paint, okay? This is something like acrylic paint, like you can see.
Donc là, vous appliquez la couleur comme une peinture classique acrylique.
And we will, we will paint directly over the surface.
Et on l'applique directement sur la surface.
As you can see, this doesn't cover completely the surface. It's a bit transparent. This is normal.
Donc en l'appliquant, vous allez voir que c'est pas une peinture qui est totalement couvrante. Elle demeure un petit peu transparente, mais c'est tout à fait normal.
And what I will do, what I usually do, is to apply two coats of this product.
En règle générale, le mieux c'est d'appliquer deux couches de cette peinture, de ce produit.
You can see that it's not totally covering the surface. It's a bit transparent, but I just let dry, and I will repeat later with another coat. You must understand that what I am applying is not a paint. It's a kind of minerals that will react later.
Ce qu'il faut comprendre, c'est que c'est pas réellement une peinture. C'est un produit de type minéral qui va ensuite réagir avec les activateurs.
You can clean with water.
Vous pouvez nettoyer votre pinceau avec de l'eau.
And it's important, not in my case because I am doing it very fast, but it's very, very important, don't mix or don't use the same brush for the different product, especially with the reactors, with the chemical reactors, because those can contaminate the basic product.
Donc ce qui est très important par contre à retenir, c'est qu'il faut, utiliser un pinceau différent, surtout quand on va venir prélever l'activateur, parce que sinon vous risquez en fait de faire réagir l'activateur à l'intérieur du pot de produit si vous utilisez le même pinceau pour prélever le produit et l'activateur.
Now, if you want different variation in your model, because each product generate different effects depending which one we are using. For example, in this robot, because I was making a lot of experiments, I used here the green one for the copper, here a black one, and you can see how many effects appear in the surface.
En fonction en fait du produit que vous allez utiliser, vous allez avoir un effet qui va varier de manière très importante. Vous l'avez vu sur l'exemple qu'il vient de montrer, avec vraiment des tonalités très différentes au niveau de la rouille.
So this is why I am painting here with another color, just to make contrast between one panels or parts and another areas of the model.
Donc là, il utilise une autre couleur de produit pour créer un contraste assez marqué entre les différents panneaux. Donc là, en l'occurrence, le toit de la tourelle et les flancs de la tourelle qui sont traités avec une autre teinte beaucoup plus foncée.
Remember that when we see a real vehicle, you can appreciate different elements, different panels, maybe a hatch or the turret are totally different rusted than other parts of the vehicle. So this is why we are using different colors.
On voit bien sur les photos de référence qu'on a des degrés de rouille qui peut différer en fonction des panneaux. Par exemple, on a des trappes qui sont plus rouillées ou moins rouillées que d'autres, d'où l'intérêt de créer justement ces contrastes, de reproduire ces contrastes sur le modèle.
This is the first step, that is to cover the model with the product that we want. Remember that there are around six, more or less, six or more. There are even one product that is only dust of a kind of iron that will allow us to fill some parts and some areas and to create very realistic effects. But I am using right now only three colors. And to avoid wait too long, because it needs time to dry, I don't recommend you to use the Hydrai with all of those products because can modify and alter the process of the rusting. So I don't recommend you to use the Hydrai. Okay, so if we have here the model with only one coat, now we must let dry and apply the second coat in with different directions. And when it is dry, we will obtain something like that. Okay? Fortunately, I was working very hard the days before to came here, and I prepared all process just to show you the completed process without needing to wait for many hours until it is dry. Especially with the reactives. When you are working with the reactives, it's convenient that you apply and let dry during one day, for example, because it is acting during all process. Even if you see that it is dry, it's not really dry. It continues working over the surface, like real rust. So more time, more effects.
Donc là, ce qu'il faut bien comprendre, c'est que bon, pour éviter déjà le temps de séchage des produits, il a travaillé en amont. Là, ce que vous voyez, c'est le résultat de l'application de deux couches, de deux couleurs différentes. Alors bien sûr, le set comprend beaucoup plus de couleurs, donc vous pouvez faire vraiment varier les couleurs. Et ensuite, ce qu'il faut aussi savoir, c'est qu'au niveau des activateurs, il faut bien les laisser sécher, parce qu'en fait, ce sont des activateurs qui vont continuer à travailler sur votre effect tant que vous les laissez en fait sécher. Donc il y a vraiment une question de temps. En outre, donc du coup, il déconseille l'utilisation du sèche-cheveux pour éviter d'altérer le résultat final de votre effet de rouille. Donc il faut laisser sécher naturellement, et quand vous mettez votre activateur, il faut laisser sécher le temps nécessaire. Tant que vous laissez sécher, l'activateur continue en fait à agir sur ce produit, ce médium, et donc va continuer à travailler l'effet de rouille.
Ok, so what I recommend you is to use a kind of recipient like this one for each activator and one different brush for each activator too.
L'effet. Donc le mieux, okay, c'est d'utiliser le rendu pour chaque activateur. Vous en avez deux. C'est d'utiliser un petit pot pour chaque, pour transvaser une petite quantité de l'activateur, et d'utiliser, ça c'est apparemment très important, d'utiliser un pinceau dédié pour chaque activateur et de ne pas mélanger les pinceaux.
Let's start with the activator type 1. If someone of you has used few model trucks long time ago, this is something similar, not exactly the same, but it's something similar. Maybe some of you remember the blue reactive for the few model trucks, right?
Donc si vous vous souvenez, alors on pourrait comparer, on pourrait comparer un petit peu ce premier activateur au liquide de brunissement pour les chenilles métalliques frioules.
And now we will start applying the product over the surface. We can apply in many ways. For example, here I will cover the whole surface.
Donc là il commence par recouvrir toute la surface avec l'activateur. L'activateur.
Yes, this is the activator number one. But you can start with the number two. So if you start with the one or the two, you will obtain different results. As well as if you mix both of them, you will obtain also very different effects.
Donc en fait, vous pouvez aussi bien commencer par l'activateur 1 ou l'activateur 2, vous allez obtenir des résultats qui seront différents. Et si vous utilisez un mélange de l'activateur 1 et 2, vous obtiendrez encore un résultat différent. Donc trois options de résultats.
Don't expect immediately action, because you need to let dry, but as much accumulation of reactors, more speed and more fast you will see the effects in the surface.
Donc ne vous attendez pas à un résultat immédiat, mais par contre plus vous allez mettre.
Okay, so let's go to use the second reactor.
Donc là il va utiliser le deuxième activateur.
Okay. And we put, you see that the color is totally different.
Donc là, la couleur est complètement différente, il est beaucoup plus bleu.
And remember to use a different brush too.
Et on va utiliser un pinceau différent.
And what we can do? Well, there are many methods to apply the effects. We can use a sponge, we can use the brush, we can apply the reactor splashing over the surface.
Donc le réacteur, vous pouvez aussi bien l'appliquer avec un pinceau qu'avec éventuellement une éponge ou encore de le projeter sous forme de gouttelettes sur la surface pour varier l'effet qui va résulter de cette réaction de l'activateur sur le produit.
Here I just start with the brass.
Donc là, il commence avec un pinceau.
And I try to avoid to cover all surface.
Et il ne va pas couvrir toute la surface avec cet activateur.
So we will create more contrast and more random effects in the end.
Il va ainsi créer beaucoup plus de contraste et beaucoup plus d'effets de variation d'effets aléatoires.
Okay. One more time, you need to clean any reactor or any product with water, always with water.
Vous nettoyez votre pinceau, hein, les activateurs se nettoient également à l'eau, tout à l'eau là.
This is why this method is very, very simple for people who are not used to paint rust in vehicles.
Ça, c'est un set qui justement s'adresse, qui est facile à utiliser et s'adresse aux maquettistes qui ont du mal à employer les autres techniques, notamment acrylique, etc.
This is good also for people who make trains. I don't know if any of you make trains. But for many cargo loads for the wagons or structures for the stations could be very interesting because you didn't need special abilities to do that.
Donc ça, c'est un set qui peut également s'adresser à ceux qui font du train parce qu'il n'y a pas besoin d'avoir une technicité particulière dans l'utilisation des acryliques. C'est un produit qui est un set qui est assez facile à utiliser pour recréer notamment tous les effets de rouille sur les wagons, sur les éléments de poutrelles, choses comme ça qu'on voit souvent dans le train.
Ok, so we have the first step. We must let dry until tomorrow. So we can go to drink something and tomorrow we can... No. No. But that is very important. If you are working with that at home, when you arrive from work, after the dinner or something like that, if you have a few minutes, apply the reactor and let's go out. You don't need a step, few minutes each day to make the whole process. So, because I have here the evolution of this, when it is dry, will be something like that. So ugly and rare, right?
Donc là, on a le résultat après avoir laissé sécher jusqu'au lendemain. C'est un petit peu l'idée de ce set, c'est que si vous disposez pas de beaucoup de temps, le soir par exemple, après le travail, eh bien vous appliquez les produits colorés, vous mettez ensuite l'activateur, et puis voilà, en quelques minutes, et puis vous laissez sécher jusqu'au lendemain, donc vous pouvez faire autre chose.
So, what is next? We must continue with only two products again. We have only those two products to achieve something more more realistic, no? So, Let's go to use again the number one. Remember that I apply here the number one. Now I will apply the number one in the size over the number two. So this is again a kind of something like binary. No? We are using only two products, and the combination of those two in different positions will generate amount of incredible effects in any surface.
Donc là, ce qu'il va faire, c'est qu'il va retravailler simplement avec l'activateur. Alors, il va par contre passer l'activateur 1 sur la zone, donc les flancs de la tourelle, où il avait passé l'activateur 2. En fait, juste avec deux produits, en fonction du type de combinaison, vous allez pouvoir créer toute une variation d'effets, l'activateur 1 sur l'activateur 2, l'activateur 2 sur l'activateur 1, etc. Donc vous avez, c'est un set qui vous offre une multitude de possibilités de variations et d'effets aléatoires.
I will apply in a different way. For example, we can apply like streaking effects.
Donc là, il l'applique en traînée verticale.
But also random and trying to avoid to repeat the same effects that with the previous one. I mean, trying to overlap, but in different positions to generate even more effects.
Donc ce qu'il faut, c'est de l'appliquer toujours de manière aléatoire, sans forcément l'appliquer sur les mêmes zones sur lesquelles on a appliqué l'activateur 2 tout à l'heure. Et vraiment d'avoir quelque chose d'aléatoire et de ne pas avoir un geste qui est répétitif ou de répéter un motif d'application.
About the quantity that we are using, we must be careful and don't apply too much quantity. Don't overflow the surface.
Vous devez bien maîtriser la quantité que vous appliquez. Il ne faut pas en appliquer trop. Il ne faut pas détremper. Merci. Détremper la surface. Donc de bien maîtriser la quantité que vous mettez, quitte à recharger régulièrement votre passoire.
And now, for the roof, I will apply the other product in a different way.
Donc maintenant, pour le toit, il va venir appliquer l'autre activateur, toujours d'une manière différente et toujours de manière aléatoire.
Humifying the surface and don't overflow it. You can concentrate more in some areas. For example, I like to concentrate more around the periscopes, no, to make more interesting. But avoid to overflow the whole surface. You can see here that it's just wet.
Donc vous pouvez accentuer un petit peu, mettre un petit peu plus de produit autour des détails, par exemple là dans le cas présent, autour des périscopes de chaque côté, mais jamais de mettre une trop grosse quantité, de détremper la surface. Vous mettez juste, faut que la surface soit mouillée, mais pas détrempée.
Ok, so this is another step and we will let dry until tomorrow. So in 1 week you can paint something very rusty, even something very big. It's not necessary to paint small things, but also you can use it for south pipes, for example, for some structures for a factory or a diorama, small cans or drums. But also you can paint something really big, a vehicle, a modern vehicle, a tractor, an excavator or truck.
Donc là, on va laisser sécher cette phase jusqu'à demain. Et en même temps, ce set vous permet à la fois de traiter des petits éléments comme des tuyaux d'évacuation rouillés, des choses comme ça, et en même temps de traiter des éléments de taille plus importante, par exemple carrément un char complet.
And after dry, we will obtain something like this. As you can see, everything is getting a more natural and realistic effects, and very random again, because you never know how it will dry, but the final look always will be realistic. So this is the previous step, but completely dry. And let's go for another effects.
Donc là, c'est ce qu'on obtient après une nuit de séchage. Hein. Le lendemain, quand on revient, c'est ce qu'on obtient. Et vous voyez que du coup, on a un effet qui est à la fois réaliste, et en même temps aléatoire en termes de rendu, des teintes, de la rouille, de localisation, des choses comme ça. Même si vous voyez que vous avez un effet qui est un petit peu plus prononcé autour des hébiscopes, hein, parce qu'il avait mis plus d'activateurs.
This time, I will make splashes in the size of the turret. Splashing with a top pick, for example, and the brass.
Donc il va réaliser cet effet en frictionnant les pinceaux, les poils d'un pinceau d'un plateau plat. Donc en fait, il va reproduire des éclaboussures de produit. Donc il va éclabousser le produit sur la surface.
Excuse me.
Yes.
If we are happy with the results after 6 hours, is it possible to cut the reaction?
Yes. The reaction with the time is going slowly and less and less and less. But if you want to cut in a moment that you like it, I recommend you to take enamel varnish, apply the enamel varnish over all surface, and then it will help to stop the reaction. Don't use acrylic varnish, because everything related with water will help in the reaction. I use also the Titan matte varnish, which is not acrylic, it's not water-based, sorry. So this will help you to stop it. When I made those samples, each day that I arrived to my office to see the results was changing every day. No? That is good because it is getting more natural and realistic. But I understand you that sometimes you need to stop and say, okay, I like exactly that, I want to stop it, then apply the varnish and the process will probably not end absolutely, but will stop and go very, very slowly. And sooner or later will stop completely. For example, this turret that I painted long time ago, that was my first experiment, is like almost 3 weeks ago, so and nothing changed, so sooner or later we'll stop. But now let's go to make the splashes using the type 2 over the size.
May I just translate this part?
Yes, yeah. Yes, please.
Donc très bonne question, effectivement. Comme c'est un produit qui continue, les activateurs continuent à réagir, alors forcément de moins en moins avec le temps. Si à un moment donné le résultat qu'on voit, l'effet qu'on voit nous satisfait, on peut bloquer en grande partie la réaction des activateurs en appliquant un vernis énamel. Alors pas de vernis acrylique, parce que comme ce sont des produits qui sont à base d'eau, le vernis acrylique risque d'accentuer la réaction, c'est-à-dire de la faire continuer. Donc un vernis énamel ou alors un vernis en bombe, des bombes titan qui sont pas des vernis acryliques. Donc c'est un bon moyen si vous souhaitez arrêter la réaction. Mais quoi qu'il arrive, à un moment donné, la réaction, elle est de moins en moins intense et elle va s'arrêter d'elle-même à un moment ou à un autre. Mais là, si par exemple le lendemain, vous êtes satisfait du résultat, eh bien pour stopper cette réaction, vous passez un vernis.
I have a question.
Yes.
So when you applied after you applied the varnish.
Yes.
You can't add any reactor because the varnish will seal and block and protect the
problem will be that you will protect completely the surface, yeah, and the reaction will lose the effectivity. Okay. But you can apply more basic product, yeah, and continue making effects in another areas of your model, for example different plates or different components, so could be interesting. But basically I think that the point is to stay working with the two reactors combined, one and the other, one and the other until you get the effects that you want. No? This is one method, but each time that I paint something, I'll always obtain different effects in different materials or also according the shapes of the model. No? It's not the same to paint something like that or something like that that is completely flat for a roof or this turret. So depending the shape, we will obtain different concentration and accumulation of the reactors and appear effects like this one here that I like a lot. Just here, that is totally different to another areas. No? So it's nice to experiment and obtain random effects that nobody can expect. No? Also, this is something that in the modeling we are always following the steps, following the path, and you must paint like this and do this and do this, and you will obtain that. With this is something more fresh. You experiment and appear effects that can help you to create something that you doesn't expect it. No? So it's the random effect, no? in the modeling, which is sometimes nice.
Donc en fait, si par exemple vous fixez le résultat avec un vernis enamel, forcément vous ne pourrez plus ajouter de réacteur dessus, il n'y aura plus de réaction. Par contre, si vous voulez accentuer les variations de tonalité, rajouter des effets, là il faut rajouter des produits, donc les différentes teintes, une des teintes de produits, et rejouer encore avec les deux activateurs. Donc l'intérêt en fait de ce produit, contrairement aux autres techniques qui suivent vraiment des procédés qui sont bien établis étape par étape, là il y a vraiment un côté aléatoire qui vous permet en même temps, c'est rafraîchissant parce que vous obtenez quelque chose qui est très réaliste et même si vous utilisez la même technique d'application de l'activateur, eh bien, en fonction du modèle, de la configuration du modèle, des zones où l'activateur va se concentrer, eh bien, vous allez obtenir des résultats qui seront très différents, même si vous avez appliqué de la même façon. Donc, il y a vraiment ce côté aléatoire qui, du coup, convient très bien à des effets réalistes de rouille.
Well, what I'm doing is just splashing the reactor number 2. To obtain small dots in the surface. And I am doing all of that just to explain you that you can apply in different ways, just painting with the brush, like any other paint, or splashing, or using a sponge that I will use later to show you other effects, no? which are very interesting. And any other that you can imagine.
Donc là, ce qu'il va faire, c'est qu'il va projeter des petites éclaboussures de produits pour restituer des petits points de rouille, hein, des effets piqués. Et c'est quelque chose, c'est un set, vous pouvez expérimenter différents types d'applications. Tout à l'heure, il nous montrera comment l'appliquer à l'éponge. Vous pouvez expérimenter plein de choses avec ce set en fonction de ce que vous souhaitez réaliser ou souhaitez découvrir comment va réagir le produit.
Ok. So after the splashes, when it will dry, we will obtain something like that. Ok. Now you can see here the small dots that appear when I splash the product, or here.
Donc après séchage, c'est ce qu'on obtient et vous avez vu qu'on a des petits points de rouille, des petites touches de rouille. Mais de rien, on a quand même un certain contrôle sur l'effet désiré.
Let's go to use the sponge. I usually have a bunch of different types of sponge. For example, this one is the used to clean the dishes, no? When you are in the kitchen. Probably all of you know that because you are who clean everything at home. but there are another ones more fine, like those for the electrical devices, For example, when we buy a hard disk or electrical component or something like that, you can find those which are more smaller. But I like to use this one that is very, very thick and very hard.
Donc là, il va travailler avec des éponges. Il a montré différents types d'éponges. Donc il aime bien finalement l'éponge un petit peu épaisse qui sert à la vaisselle. Merci. C'est juste que je pense que par exemple en France, on n'a pas forcément ce type d'éponge pour faire la vaisselle. Et sinon, il y a les mousses d'emballage qui présentent différentes densités. Donc il serait peut-être bon de commercialiser des éponges espagnoles pour la vaisselle. Je sais pas, moi j'ai jamais croisé.
Il y a les Belges qui font la vaisselle.
Non, mais des Français aussi, mais des éponges comme ça, j'en ai pas.
C'est des éponges plus dures, tu vois, gratuites. Pas en métal, mais.
Ouais, mais là, ça a l'air d'être une Spontex un peu épaisse, non? Ça a l'air d'être, oui, mais alors épaisse, très épaisse.
Well, if we were using this recipient, now we will use the cap to put here a bit of product.
Donc il va utiliser le couvercle de son récipient précédent dans lequel il avait versé l'activateur. Donc là, il va mettre l'activateur dans le couvercle pour en.
Remember to be very organized in your table. Eh? I always use the left side for the product number one. And the right side for the number two, and try to keep everything separate, okay?
Donc il organise son plan de travail en fonction des activateurs, c'est-à-dire qu'il met un activateur avec notamment le petit capuchon qui contient cet activateur d'un côté gauche, et l'autre activateur avec le bouchon qui contient cet activateur côté droit pour éviter en fait au bout d'un moment de mélanger les activateurs.
And with the sponge, we will make a different kind of effect in the surface. Like a mapping, like a bigger areas.
Donc là, il applique le produit avec l'éponge.
And more concentrate with more quantity of product.
Il y a des endroits où il va venir concentrer un petit peu plus le produit.
In that case, I will apply all over the surface of the turret roof. And size.
Donc là, il va appliquer cet activateur avec l'éponge sur l'ensemble des côtés de la tourelle ainsi que sur la plaque du toit de tourelle.
What would happen if you mix?
If you mix both?
Yeah, you make a mistake. If you
mix both components at the same time, for example in my sponge with the brass, the reaction will be very strong and very fast in the surface because both reactives work double when they are together and can be a big nuclear explosion. I'm more like that, but in the model, no? So if you want to control slowly and nice, like the other guy say, what happens if I want to stop in that moment? It's better to control one by one because it will be easier to stop when you like it. Because we both at the same time can make a reaction and start making bubbles and.
How much time between using one and two? How many hours?
Well, under my experience, but I'm still discovering many things, so that is even new for me. But under my experience, I recommend you between one layer and the other, just leave it 24 hours. It's like I told you before, you arrive from your work or from you do your things, you go to your room, apply a little product, and let's go with your family, watch TV or do another model. And the next day, after 24 hours, you will see the total effects. Is when it is almost totally dry and the reaction is almost stop or finish. Yeah, so this is my recommendation. Don't be in a hurry. If you have 1 week, start Monday and the Sunday your model will be finished. Yeah. Just.
But you do not intend to issue a product which would stop the reaction.
What, sorry?
Because you say after 24 hours most of it has stopped. Do you intend to issue another product which would stop the reaction?
another product.
After 24 hours, it would stop the reaction, then you can do number two.
No, you don't need to apply any other product to stop the reaction. Mm-hmm. Just it will stop alone.
Okay.
Almost. Yeah. Stop. Almost stop. So you can start working with the other reactive without any problem. But after 24 hours, it lose the effectivity, more or less, after 24 hours. If I do that now, for example, this is the first sample that we were making today, and still you cannot see anything. Just a little you can appreciate here, the first effects. But if you see this one tomorrow, you will see like this one that we saw you in the second stage. So this is why you need hours to see the reaction of the activators. You need time. This is why I prepared all process in different turrets just to show you what happened after 24 hours. Because here could be impossible to see it. Of course, if you try to accelerate with the high dryer and a lot of an amount of activator, you will see something. But to see the real effects and the total potential of this product, you need to wait. You need to be patient. You will obtain many incredible effects, but working slowly, trying to leave dry during 24 hours. Is the only point.
Bon, je remplace le traducteur quelques minutes, il a un problème technique. En résumé de tout ce qui était dit ici, ça ne va pas être facile, c'est toujours en phase d'expérimentation, donc il est possible, enfin les deux réactifs ensemble peuvent réagir très fort. Donc évitez quelque peu de les mélanger en même temps sur, sur votre maquette. Par contre, au bout de 24 heures, l'effet du réactif 1 ou 2 sera extrêmement visible et commencera très largement à diminuer au niveau de sa vitesse de dégradation des produits. Donc c'est un produit qui demande de la patience, simplement, et qui est toujours en stage de découverte, même par lui, au niveau des réactions. C'est de l'extra concentré de ce qui est dit.
On est patient, quoi.
Voilà.
Well, when our model will drive tomorrow, we will see something like that. This is the process with the sponge, but after it is dry, after 24 hours. Can you see those amazing effects?
Donc ça, c'est le résultat après 24 heures de séchage, après l'application du réacteur, de l'activateur à l'éponge, et vous avez vu un petit peu les effets que vous pouvez obtenir et le réalisme de ces derniers.
In fact, this is extremely difficult to make painting.
Ça, si vous voulez le peindre à l'acrylique, c'est très difficile à reproduire ce genre d'effet avec juste de la peinture acrylique.
Well, what we can do now in this process looks nice, but let's do it in another way, the effects. And now we will make again streaking effects with the number two. Remember that the previous one was the number one. Remember what I told you. Jump and or a switch between number one, number two, number two, number one. We are jumping from one to the other and accumulating the effects.
Donc là, il prend maintenant l'activateur 2 pour faire des effets de traînée qu'il avait fait tout à l'heure, mais avec l'activateur 1. Donc en fait, vous faites toujours des plus ou moins des allers-retours entre l'activateur 1 et l'activateur 2 pour compléter et enrichir les effets et les rendre encore plus aléatoires comme l'est la rouille.
So now, let's go to paint like streaking, making lines, vertical lines. Even here, maybe we can choose a more fine brush. That will allow us more accuracy when we are painting.
Donc il prend un pinceau un petit peu plus fin pour avoir une application plus précise, pour mieux contrôler l'application et ses traînées verticales.
This is the same method that when we are painting streaking in our models with oils or enamels, just trying to paint random lines, one of them more thick, another one more fine, and different distance, different intensities to make more realistic.
C'est un petit peu la même technique que lorsque on reproduit des effets de traînées verticales avec les huiles ou les enamels. Donc vous faites des traînées qui sont certaines plus fines que d'autres, d'autres un petit peu plus épaisses. Vous variez la largeur de vos traînées.
Now you can understand that if we apply the activators all over surface since the beginning, we will obtain just a uniform surface with no difference or with no variety of effects. Eh? So this is why we must try to apply the product in different areas each time and in different ways.
Si on s'était contenté comme au début d'appliquer l'activateur de manière uniforme sur les surfaces, on ne pourrait pas obtenir toutes ces variations d'effets et ces variations de tonalité. Donc il faut varier la méthode d'application et utiliser différents types d'applications sur l'activateur 1 et l'activateur 2.
We can also concentrate more in some areas. For example, here we can make a kind of wash with the activator.
Donc on peut appliquer aussi l'activateur de manière un petit peu plus dense, comme un avis, un jus.
Okay, this is another step. One more time, I put the products for the number two, all brushes and all tools in one side to don't contaminate the other side in my table.
Donc encore une fois, il fait bien attention de positionner sur son plan de travail l'activateur 2 qu'il a utilisé avec le petit capuchon du côté droit et de bien laisser l'activateur 1 avec son petit capuchon chargé de produits sur le côté gauche pour éviter de mélanger les deux produits.
Okay. So, well, even now, because there are more accumulation of reactives, you can see that it start working very fast in some areas. It become to be dry, and you can see some effects very fast.
Donc là, comme il y a eu plusieurs applications d'activateurs, il y a forcément beaucoup d'activateurs sur les surfaces. Donc en rajoutant un petit peu d'activateurs, vous voyez que l'effet commence déjà à se voir et que l'activateur commence déjà à agir et ça se perçoit visuellement.
And this will be the effects after it is dry.
Voilà le résultat. Après séchage.
You can see some kind of lines. Of course, the lines are more evident over some areas of the previous layer than in another areas without too much product. No? So here I have two more examples of the drying effects. Let me show you. All of those are in the same stage. No? So here we have three examples made in the same way, with the same product, with the same process, at the same time, and each one is different to the other ones.
Donc là, vous avez trois tourelles qui ont été traitées de la même manière, c'est-à-dire avec les différentes étapes que Mick vous a montrées. Donc de la même manière, avec les mêmes types d'applications, les mêmes techniques d'application, et vous voyez que vous avez trois résultats qui sont différents.
Obviously, over the areas that I use this product and other areas with the other product, everything changes and the reactive have a different look. But for example, this one, depending if I concentrate a bit more or not, can be different in one or in the other, no? OK. can be a bit different. Also, the concentration in the periscope here is like more orange, and this one is more sun. But I made exactly the same in both places. Eh? So it's random, yes, but the final look will be more or less the same in all of them, but each one will be different. For example, this is good if we are making the typical idea of a factory, a tank factory with many turret, and all of turret are rusty outside of the factory. No? So we can paint all of them at the same time, with the same method, with the same product, and each one will be completely different to the other. No? For people who make dioramas, this is a very good option to avoid to do this hard and complex process of painting. That also, this one represents something totally different to this one. This is in another different condition than this, than what we can obtain with this.
Donc là, imaginez par exemple que vous soyez, que vous ayez envie de représenter à l'extérieur d'une usine des tourelles abandonnées, rouillées, etc. Et bien là, vous pouvez traiter vos différentes tourelles, vos différents éléments de la même manière, et vous aurez malgré tout trois ou plusieurs résultats, plusieurs effets, plusieurs rendus qui seront différents, et chaque tourelle sera présentera un caractère unique au niveau de ses effets de rouille. Donc c'est aussi l'intérêt de ce set. Ça vous permet de travailler en même temps, mais d'obtenir des résultats, d'obtenir une variation au niveau de l'effet de rouille sur les éléments qui auront été traités.
Okay. So at this point is when I decide to stop. And now we can continue working with another product. We can work with pigments, we can work with washes, with acrylics, and we can continue making more rich and more attractive our model. Only this is more than enough when we are... Yes?
Do you have to cover it with a varnish?
Yes, now it could be nice to cover with a varnish. I have here in my... I was not able to find it right now, and it's not necessary to do now in front of you, but I recommend you to cover with enamel or lacquer varnish, matte, always matte, no satin, no glossy. Why? Because everything that we see rusty is always matte, except if it's wet or humid, okay? So if we want to give a nice appearance or something really rusty and unrealistic, must be completely matte. Anyway, now I can continue working. For example, I can apply a pigment, a metal gun pigment, to make some shiny areas. For example, here I made it in this example. This is a kind of abandoned turret, and here you can see some shiny areas that is. Because the friction of some people playing around, no? Or jumping over the abandoned tank. And we can make that easily with a metallic pigment. So we can do something similar in our model.
Donc là, après, ce qui est possible après ce traitement, c'est d'utiliser des méthodes plus classiques, d'ajouter des effets avec des pigments, avec des énamels, des lavis ou des huiles pour enrichir un petit peu, si vous souhaitez, l'effet, le contraste, ce genre de choses. Là, ce que Mick va faire, c'est qu'il va travailler avec des pigments métalliques, enfin pigments couleur gunmetal, pour reproduire un petit peu l'effet d'abrasion sur des surfaces sur lesquelles on aurait pu marcher ou choses comme ça.
I use always the finger, or we can use a rubber brush. It's in another place, my rubber brush. You know that you can buy a rubber brush with a rubber in the top, and that is very good to apply the metallic pigments, but because I have it here right now, you can apply directly with the finger in some areas.
Donc vous pouvez appliquer les pigments, là Mick va le faire avec son doigt, mais vous pouvez également appliquer ce genre de pigment avec un pinceau à bout à l'extrémité, comment t'appelles ça? Oui, des shapers à extrémité de points de caoutchouc.
Small touches is more than enough. Don't overdo it when you are doing that over rusty parts.
Donc, faut quand même bien contrôler pour pas l'application même avec le doigt, pour pas recouvrir des zones trop importantes.
Sometimes less is more. Many aspects of the lives, but just a little will be enough to give a metallic sensation.
Donc on en met juste par endroit pour donner cette impression un peu métallique. Le trop étant l'ennemi du bien.
You will discover that with those products, I mean those, have a raw texture that is the metallic component that will be reacted by the reactors. No? So they will give us always a kind of texture. So you must keep on mind, if you are making something really small, for example in 1/70 seconds, be careful because it will give you a raw texture in the surface, like you can appreciate here in any of those examples. Let me show you. Maybe.
Donc, faut garder quand même à l'esprit que ce type de produit, puisqu'on fait réagir des particules métalliques qui sont contenues dans les produits colorés qui réagissent avec l'activateur, eh bien, ça va vous donner une texture.
If we have something like that, we can apply enamel washes, for example. Okay.
Donc là, il va travailler avec un lavis enamel de couleur rouille.
It's not necessary, but I am doing just to explain you that you can do it if you want. Okay.
Pas forcément nécessaire, bien entendu, mais il va le faire pour vous montrer que c'est tout à fait possible de revenir travailler sur les surfaces avec des méthodes et des produits qui me sont maintenant classiques.
But look what happened when I apply the enamel washes. So be careful, okay? Because it will expand very fast by capillarity. So my recommendation is to work with pigments more than enamel washes, okay? Because it will expand in many directions.
Donc il conseille quand même plutôt de retravailler par-dessus ce type de résultat, ce type de set, de retravailler dessus avec des pigments plutôt qu'avec des lavis, parce qu'en fait les lavis par capillarité vont s'étendre un petit peu partout, où en fait vous aurez moins de contrôle. Ou alors il faudra vraiment l'appliquer par petites touches.
Here we can paint some streakings, we want. Yeah, but you can see how it expands and it can create very ugly effects if we are not enough careful. It's difficult to control. It's not like when we are painting a turret like this with acrylics, that is more easy to control than over something like that. Well, also we can use oil, oil brushes, or any other thing to make some effects.
And so, on peut ajouter des lavis enamel. On peut également ajouter des touches de couleur rouille avec des oil brochures ou tout type de produits équivalents.
For example, this. But because the surface is very raw. Will be difficult to work with those products.
Et comme vous avez une surface en fait qui est pas lisse, qui est texturée du fait du traitement avec le set, bah vous allez avoir un peu plus de mal à contrôler et à reprendre les effets à l'énamel ou à l'huile.
here I am damping and humifying all surface.
Donc là il détrempe la, il détrempe la surface avec, avec du diluant énamel pour pouvoir reprendre et retravailler l'effet des, du lavis énamel couleur bouille.
Trying to blend the lines of rust.
Donc, si vous voulez, essayer de fondre en fait ces traînées de rouille.
Now we can use the hot dryer to accelerate the process.
Donc là par contre vous pouvez utiliser un sèche-cheveux pour accélérer le processus de séchage des, de l'énamel.
Obviously, if I am applying just thinner, for example here, when it is dry, it will disappear, no? So now looks like everything is dark, but it's not true. The colors will be like before, after it is dry.
Donc là, sur les zones où on applique du diluant énamel, ça apparaît foncé, mais en séchant, vous allez retrouver la couleur d'origine.
I am burning my hand, my fingers. Oh, this is powerful. I need it for myself. Okay, et voilà. Eh? More realistic, even more realistic, thanks to the washes. The oil is still fresh, obviously, because need more time for dry. But where I apply the washes, you can see even more attractive than before.
Donc là, vous voyez qu'avec les énamels et les huiles, vous avez ajouté du contraste et visuellement c'est beaucoup plus l'effet, beaucoup plus intéressant, beaucoup plus réaliste. Alors les énamels avec le sèche-cheveux séché, les huiles il leur faut un petit peu plus de temps, c'est pour ça que vous voyez encore les huiles qui ne sont pas sèches et qui créent des zones un petit peu plus foncées là où elles ont été appliquées.
One important thing that I want that you appreciate is that I always try to create contrast in the model that I paint. Always don't do it in both sides. Just do it in one side or here, just to create contrast between the different components and different parts of the model. This is something that you must apply not only when you are making something rusty, but when you are making anything in your models, even in a plane, when you are making the different panels in a plane or in a tank, try to make something different in each area of your model. That is extremely important and is one of my best advice for you.
Donc le meilleur conseil que Mick souhaite vous donner, c'est de toujours créer du contraste sur les modèles, par exemple en différenciant par le biais de contraste ajouté ici avec la rouille, différenciant les éléments qui constituent par exemple le toit. Donc pas de faire des choses qui sont symétriques, mais d'ajouter un effet d'un côté et pas forcément de l'autre, etc. pour bien différencier les éléments qui constituent un blindé ou même un avion sur les différents panneaux pour pouvoir mettre en valeur ces éléments et créer du contraste.
Mm-hmm. And another example, just to end, using the pigments, I have black, dark rust and a light rust, okay? So we can use here too. And don't forget it, trying to create contrast one more time.
Donc sur cette tourelle, il va utiliser trois teintes de pigments qui vont du noir au, à la rouille foncée et rouille claire. Et en appliquant ces pigments, il va essayer toujours de jouer sur le, de créer du contraste.
One more time, remember the examples that I showed you before, where you can see areas with many bright colors, dark areas, smoke, ashes. So we must try to represent all of this in our models.
Gardez à l'esprit aussi et sous les yeux les images de référence qui permettent de constater qu'on a des zones qui sont très foncées et des zones qui sont très très claires.
And before I blend it, I will use the light rust.
Il applique la dernière couleur de pigment, rouille claire, avant de venir les fondre.
One more time, this is just examples of what we can do over the surface. Obviously, if we combine this with the washes, with the oil, with the Jurass products, we can obtain incredible, incredible things that the people will be shocked with our model if they see it in a model contest. No? And one more time, this is so easy to achieve because the base is given by the Jurass products. So if we arrive to this point, will be very easy to combine with washes, oils, or pigments, creating even more variety and more effects. Don't forget that there are others, like the copper, that can give you a look like this one, for figures or for sculptures from the streets. And there are another different colors that give you also a different appearance. So that's all about this kind of rust. I don't know if any of you have questions regarding that or any other question, even if it's not related with the rust, I will be happy to reply you because here I have many products and many stuff. So if any of you have questions about something different, maybe I can try to do right now.
Can you combine this with metallic paints?
You mean lacquer metallic paints?
There are different, there are acrylic as well, huh?
Yes, you mean to apply this product over the metallic?
Yes.
Yes. You in fact, remember the base... I have it here. Remember that the base color, when I started, was black. But can be black, can be metallic, can be green, can be any other. The black is good because it's already like a dark color for all of this, no? And it is helping me to apply the rust product. But you can apply in some areas over something metallic without any problem. For example, something painted in iron or steel or any other. So, in fact, many people are using this for wargame and fantasy and Warhammer 40,000 and all of those things. And they are combining metallics with normal paints with the rust products.
But if you use acrylic metallic paint, you have to apply a varnish over it.
If you use acrylic metallic paints, yeah, or enamel or lacquer, doesn't matter.
Yeah.
This doesn't attack to the previous base.
Yeah. But you said that you can't apply straight acrylic paints on top of your rust. That works both ways. It means if I apply metallic paint...
You mean to paint metallic over this?
No, no, no.
Under. Yeah. It's not a problem if it's lacquer, enamel, or acrylic.
So no varnish required.
No. Just paint the metallic. Doesn't matter if it's Tamiya or Mr. Hobby. Or acrylic paints, doesn't matter, or AMO acrylic paints, doesn't matter. Yeah. You don't need to protect to apply this one over.
Okay.
You don't need to protect.
It will not attack the acrylic metallic paint.
No. Well, maybe I doesn't try, for example, with, for example, Alclad.
Yes.
Alclad type. Because Alclad is very strong paint, even if the paint is very thin, they are very strong and resist a lot.
Okay.
I think, I am not sure 100%, but I think that this doesn't attack either, because this is more like water based.
Mm-hmm.
What attack Alclad paints? Lacquer thinners, or other lacquer paints, or other lacquer varnish can attack the Alclad.
Yeah.
It's when we paint planes, I don't know if you guys paint also metallic planes. The Alclad are very fragile. If you apply over enamel washes or lacquer paints, but this is why we usually apply aqua gloss varnish over Alclad, no? Because it's a kind of acrylic varnish. In that case, I think that doesn't attack, but because this is something that is acrylic, it's water based. So it's the only thing that doesn't attack Alclad. The only thing.
Donc en résumé, vous pouvez mettre ce que vous voulez comme première couche. Le produit n'attaquera pas, c'est à base d'eau. Donc ça n'attaquera pas, vous pouvez mettre du métallique, vous pouvez mettre des peintures Tamiya, vous pouvez mettre des peintures, tout ce que vous voulez. Il y a juste au niveau de l'Alclad. Mais j'avoue que j'ai pas très bien compris pourquoi l'Alclad risque d'être attaqué. C'est très fin, donc c'est peut-être ça au point de un niveau de résistance.
Ok. So, more questions or doubts that you have? You...
They're all experts.
No, I see. And probably more than me. No, the good point is that each time that I go to a model contest, I am always learning from other people. I always discover something new thanks to the questions of the people, no? That hey, this works like this or that, and you say, oh my God, I never tried. So it's a good way to experiment by myself when I come back home. And of course, nobody is expert in the modeling, because each time that we make something new is something new for us. So today we are making a Sherman tank in green color, but if tomorrow we want to make a BTR in Ukraine, how the hell we do that? We have two options, or send something to Ukraine to blow up, or paint by ourselves here using this kind of products, or something similar, no? But this is the first time that I make the explanation about the URAS products. I hope you find it interesting. And one more time, if you have any question, and if I can do it right now here, I will be very happy to explain it.
Blending the pigments in that's
blending the pigments?
Yeah.
Like I made here?
Yeah.
You saw how I made so simple. Usually, over very flat surfaces, the pigment fit like the hell. Okay, so try to avoid applying pigment over shiny or glossy surfaces. This is why the Ferrari cars and Lamborghini are very clean, no? Because it's completely flat surface. And this have a explanation. Anyone have a pen or a pencil here? Anyone? A crayon? Yeah, or something. Yeah. Fantastic. Let me explain you something very basic for the people who are interested in pigments. And this is very important for people who make planes. Also, planes or modern cars or things like that. Look that. Matte satin and glossy are textures, not paint. Okay? So if they are textures, what happens when you have a surface that is completely shiny or glossy, like a Ferrari, Lamborghini, or something like that. That the surface is totally flat and straight like this one. When we have a surface that is satin, the surface is something like this. And when our surface is totally matte, the surface is something like this, like mountains. Okay?
Vous avez, à l'échelle x5000, le premier, c'est quand vous avez des surfaces qui sont brillantes, puis des surfaces qui sont
satinées,
et puis mat. Donc ça, c'est au niveau de la croche.
Satin and matte. Well, what happened with this? And this is extremely, extremely important for the modeling. And you must understand that if you want to work properly. With a glossy surface, if we put pigments, what happened? That the particles of the pigments are over the surface and they can be blow up easily because they cannot stay inserted in the texture of the varnish. Eh? So this is why when we apply pigments over a glossy surface, if you take your finger and you clean it, you will drag all pigments easily. Also, because the surface is completely flat like a mirror or like the glass, the reflection of the light is coming in one direction and reflect in another direction. This is why the signs, the highlights, the shiny in a Ferrari or Lamborghini, you will see very sharp lines or reflection of the lights. This is what gives us the sensation of something glossy. But when it is satin, the light is coming and it reflects in more directions. And when the surface is matte, the light is coming and it is reflected in many, 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 many directions. And this is why we see the shiny, very blur and diffuse. So, that is how our brain and our eyes understand the different textures. And there are only three, glossy, satin, and matte. If you enter in your own car each morning, and you will see many components that are satin, another are matte, another are glossy. For example, maybe some buttons in your car are glossy, but the carpet in the floor is completely matte, and your leather seats in your car are satin. This is why we interpret the things around us in different ways. So this is important when we are making models. And now is when the conclusion is the most important for today. If you are painting a tank, and you paint the matte, the effects, the washes, the metal, and everything, and finally, when you finish your Sherman tank, you apply the matte coat to all of this, you are completely destroying the reality of your model, because it's not like the real thing. If you see something around here, or even in a Sherman tank, in the reality, you will see many components in satin, glossy, and matte. Even many tanks in the Second World War was not matte, was satin or even glossy, but due to the action of the dust and hair and other elements and discoloration from the sun, make our model make the Shermans or the Panzer IV more matte appearance. And what is the relation between this and the pigments? The connection is that when we apply the pigments over a matte surface, the pigment will fit very well in the surface. Is what happened here. Because this is very matte, the pigments fit here very well, and even now I cannot remove it. I cannot remove it, because it's very matte. And the particles of the pigment is here. Can you see it? But if my surface is like this, this is a glossy, right? So I will use the same pigment. I know this is a wash, sorry. And you will see what a mess. Okay, this is our beautiful plane. And now I want to apply the pigments over the glossy surface of your plane. Okay. Ah, very nice. Ah. But ta-chan, I remove it completely because it's glossy. Remember, it's totally flat like this line, and the pigments have no place where they stay. Okay? So if you are making planes, apply a satin or matte varnish to the end if you want to apply pigments. For example, a plane in the desert in Africa. Then could be possible to apply pigments. But if your plane is totally metallic and glossy and new, will be difficult to apply pigments over that surface. The same with the tanks. The same with the tanks. This is why when modelers want to apply pigments over a vehicle, we always try to mix with enamel products like this. Let me show you 1 second. For example, this is Middle East pigment, and I want to apply over my Panther 3 in Africa Corps. Okay? But my model is a bit satin. And why my Panther 4 or Panther 3 is satin? Because I need to create a contrast between the sun color of my tank and the sun color of the pigment from the dust. So this is why my tank will be satin and the pigment will be matte. How can I fix this one over the surface? For example, mixing it over, well, I have on here the right color, but doesn't matter. Africa does. We can mix it with a bit of enamel product. Well, this is matte, but there are many colors like this one. So we can mix a bit of pigment with a bit of enamel, and then the pigment will be fixed over the surface. But only if the surface is satin or glossy. If the surface is totally matte like this one, we can start working here without any problem with the pigments. I have models painted 20 years ago that have pigments over the surface and still there. So, for example, this is Ravel pigment. That also the rusty vehicles have dust. Okay. So I can apply here around. Be careful over matte surfaces because I cannot remove it later because it fit too much. I remove the excess. And that's all. I cannot remove it. It's still there. Okay? Because the surface is totally matte. The same with any other color. So just keep on mind. The texture are very important when we are using the different weathering products, like the pigments, washes, and everything. So here you can apply the pigment directly without any other addition. But if your model is satin, remember to mix it with something to help to fix. I don't know if that was your question, yeah. More or less. Yes. Okay. More things. For example, one question for all of you. Where do you find problems when you are making models? Where you are finding more problems? For example, with your wife? That, or... Nah, just kidding. Some people have more problems with the chipping, other with the washes, other with the base color, other because are very lazy and they don't want to pay models and just collect. So where is your main problems when you are making models?
Because
In?
Decals.
In the decals, with the decals. You make planes, right?
Plane tanks, I mix a little.
And you have problems, why? Because always appear the relief of the decal. Well, very important for the decals. The surface must be completely glossy, and the people who make planes know that very well, right? Very, very, very glossy. And without texture, because if you apply the best color and the surface is not too straight, you will have problems with the varnish too. So the surface must be completely flat and very glossy, very, very, extremely glossy. That will help you to avoid the bubbles in the decals. And the second and the most important is the decal products that you use. Okay? For example, at AIMO we have two decal products that you must apply before and after, and the thickness of the decal almost disappear. And after you apply the decals, always you must varnish in matte. And then everything will be very integrated, because the decal is satin and the surface is glossy, and to unify both must be varnished with matte varnish. And then all shininess of the decal will disappear. So for me also was a problem until I discovered that must be glossy, decal, decal products and matte varnish, that's all. And the problem disappeared completely. So, more problems or dupes? Everybody know everybody, everything, no? Well, I hope you like it, the paint demonstration from today. For me was an amazing experience to drive from Spain to here. 1,200 kilometers more or less, just to stay here today with you, all of you, yes?
Within the set, is there a kind of color chart?
A kind of?
Color chart.
Color?
Color chart.
Color chart. Yeah. There are a booklet with instruction, and I bring here with me a color chart that maybe you can take photos also. I will find, I will share it right now. This is a kind of booklet with instruction, how to apply the product and explanations, and it's more easy to understand than here, because it's one color with reactive one, reactive two, and combination of both. Another color, one, two, and combination, so it's more easy to understand. More questions or something?
One last question.
Yes?
The primer you use, you said Titan, is that a MIG product?
Titan is a primer from Italy. It's a very high quality primer. We work with them and we distribute them. I think that Domino have the Titan sprays. And under my opinion, from all of them that I tested in the market, we chose this one because it's excellent.
Is it matte or glossy?
It's matte, matte. Totally matte. Okay. And it's very fast. I cannot live now without them because I primer all my models very fast, and the surface is always very smooth and it's perfect. Always is good.
Is it a tin or a...
It's a big can, so you have for many models, okay. For many models. So, and there are many colors, red primer, dark yellow, metallic colors, green, all of them. But the primer is very important, especially if you are painting with acrylics, to protect correctly the surface, and will help to the acrylic to fit well the surface. And especially for this kind of product, also I recommend you, mostly for those.
Thank you.
Okay. More questions around? Well, so from my side, thank you very much to stay here, all of you. I appreciate that you spend your day with me and not doing something much better and productive. But I want to remind you that I will stay also in Eindhoven the next few days. I will make another demonstration for matte and hair effects, and also after this I will travel to Germany. I will stay also in Hobbitein in Holland, that is very close to here. But anyway, remember that I will upload that video to internet in the next days. So if someone wants to remember the product or the order of everything, will be in YouTube. And that's all, friends. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy this evening.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Emilien, for your help, and the other translator. Thank you.
Discover many more videos on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and activate notifications. Thank you for watching.